Wolves hockey fans, welcome to another edition of the Wolves Hockey Show. For your weekly highlights, news clips, and information on the Wolves program. We have, as special co-host this week...
Oh, my name is Holt Schwarm.
Welcome back to the show, Holt.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
I don't know if you know, but this is the number one rated hockey-themed show on Lakes Region Public Access, bringing you all this weekly information on all the things going on in our program. So it's good to have you back.
Yeah, thank you. It's awesome to be on again. It's a great show. I love it.
Rumor has it that, you know, if we have close to ballparking at 20 to 30,000 views a week, your mom is watching about 29,000.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, she's a big watcher of this show.
She's a number one fan all the way in what part of Ohio?
Columbus.
All the way in Columbus, Ohio, Ellen Schwarm. Big shout out to Ellen.
Yep. Shout out to you, Mom. Love you.
Well, big week for the Wolves. A lot of stuff going on, right?
Right, yeah.
So tell me about what the 14s did.
So with the 14s, they played this weekend. They took a 5-1 victory over the Avalanche.
Yep.
And then in their second game, they had a 3-3 tie against Manchester.
So an unbeaten weekend again for the 14s. The 14s are right now ranked number one in New Hampshire Tier 2 hockey, so they're doing really, really well. We've got a couple clips we're going to show you right now. All right, here's our weekly award winners for the Wolves U14s. The 5-1 victory, you had Aiden McKenzie there as one of our award winners. Then in the 3-3 tie, you had Ben Libby and Trevor Lemire. Great job, guys. Great showing for the unbeaten U14s. And here's a highlight from the 5-1 U14 win. Offensive zone faceoff for the Wolves. They're up on the power play here. Clean faceoff win. Gets it to the point. Nice tip screen. Evan Guerin as the net front presence. Great job, Wolves. They beat the Avalanche 5-1.
So,
Schwarm, those are some pretty good clips from the 14s. What do you think?
Oh, yeah, those are some great clips out there. Those kids are looking like they're getting a lot better and better throughout each day.
Absolutely. They're crushing it right now.
Yeah. So, tell me about the U16s, Coach.
16s had a good weekend. We only played one game on Sunday. This was the fourth time this season we played the New Hampshire Monarchs, and we beat them for the fourth time. 4-2 win down at Tri-Town Arena in Hooksett. We got a clip we're going to show you right now. So Wolves are nursing a 2-1 lead here late in the game. Good forecheck by Owen Guerin's line. Able to intercept the pass, Gage Winner right there. Owen makes a nice play to get it to Gage Winner. And as Ron Burgundy says, milk was a bad choice. Winter buries the game winner. 4-2, Wolves win. So, Troma, tell me. EHLP, they've been battling all season. I think they have 10 games where they've been either winning or losing end of a one-goal game. That's incredibly close hockey all season. It means they're showing the team that they're really ready to compete every day and play those close games. Tell me how they did this past weekend.
All right, so we played against the Vermont Lumberjacks, and unfortunately we fell 3-2, but in that game I felt like we were very close with them. I felt like it was a tight battle, and we're making steps in the right direction, going right into playoffs.
You know, those teams that have those wide margins of victory, 5-1, 6-2, 7-2, whatever it is, you know, that's not playoff hockey. Playoff hockey is one or two goal games, and if you learn how to play and be comfortable in those environments, it usually says and shows how you can do in the playoffs. So although you may not be on the positive end of those results, playing those games is a positive.
Right. Yeah. No, definitely.
We got a couple clips we're going to show you right now.
And here's a clip here in the EHLP game. It was a really close game, and we played really well against each other. Here's Andreas Matika, gives it right over to Joey McCready, and Joey McCready puts it into the back of the net. And as Andrew Trimble once said, scratch my back with a hacksaw. Wolves got the goal, but they fell 3-2.
So, Schwarm, tell me about McCready. He started off a little bit slow as he adjusted to a higher level of hockey than he was playing down in Tennessee. What has he brought to the back end for the Wolves EHLP?
I would say that he's mostly brought, really good defense. I mean, he puts his body out there a lot. He's always blocking shots out there, especially on the penalty kill. He's a great penalty kill guy. Overall, I think he's a fantastic player, and he's been a great addition to our defensive unit.
I couldn't agree more. He's a 2002 birth year player, so he's got a lot of room for improvement. But we've seen that improvement already in a short period of time, a 3-4 month span, him going from a guy who was kind of earning his minutes now to being getting now trusted minutes on the power play, on the penalty kill, as you said, in close games. So good job by Joey.
Yeah, great job, Joey.
Now we have some EHL stuff coming up.
Yeah.
What did you think of their week so far? Well, you know, you watched a couple of the games. What did you think of their week?
They look like they've been clicking a lot. They look like they finally, you know, have been playing up to where I believe that they can, and it's been showing. They're on a 5-game win streak right now.
Yeah, they're crushing it.
Yeah, they're
finally worked their way into those power rankings.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they've been off the power rankings pretty much the whole year, so at least they finally get on it.
Yeah, you know, even though you beat, you know, the top teams over and over, and you have 4 wins against the Avalanche, inexplicably, the Avalanche are still ranked ahead of them. I don't know how that works.
Yeah.
But I'm not a mathematician. I'm just a hockey coach.
No, I think it's just the league.
We have a couple clips we're going to show you right now. So Wolves are able to catch the Lumberjacks here on a bad line change in the second period. Richie Colarusso sends it up to newly acquired Patrick Marcinkiewicz, and he puts it up where the baby sleeps, right upstairs. Marcinkiewicz, 5-goal night. Here's a great individual effort by a player who's been earning his minutes all season. Andrew Lantry makes a nice play in the neutral zone. And bingo, bango, wiggle me, proper, it is back of the net. Andrew Lantry on the finish. Great job, Andrew. And here's their recent victory over the Lumberjacks on Sunday. Wolves going to work on the power play. Send my love to Latvia. It goes Latvian to Latvian, and Jelenskis scores backdoor. Wolves win the game 6-4, completing the 5-game win streak. Nice job, guys. So, Holt, the EHL team's playing well. Like we said, 5-game win streak. Another team that's been playing well is the U16 team. Mm-hmm. Right now, they're 17-9-1 on the season. They've had a couple pauses because of the COVID restrictions in the state. What have you seen out of some of the U16 guys?
Some guys that I've seen really is like Zach Orwig. You know, he's in the games he's been up with us, he's been playing really well. There's another one, Nick Therrien's been playing really good. And a guy on the 16s, Fisher Galuzzo, has been playing, you know, extremely well. He's got the big C on there. He's taking some huge responsibilities.
Well, you know, Fisher's the captain of that team, and he's done a good job all season. He's got our next interview with Hiro Shwomo.
So here I'm interviewing the man, the myth, the legend, Fisher Galuzzo. He is the captain of the U16 team. He's a really good buddy of mine, and know each other for about 2 seasons now. So, Fisher, kind of tell me about your background, where you started. And
it's an honor to be here. I started playing hockey about 6 years ago in my home state of Wyoming, and really took off when I got accepted into Sidney Crosby Hockey School. That's where I really found my love for hockey, and ever since then, I've been on the grind. And my last season in Wyoming was 2 years ago, and I ended up venturing out here to the New England Wolves. And I've been here since last season and this season on the U16 team.
So what kind of got you, what made you want to come to the Wolves? What attracted you to come here to the Lakes region?
The Wolves' depth of development really drew me in. I'm here to get better and show up every day. So,
yeah, we're all here to get better, if you can tell. So you're the captain of the U16 team. So how does it really like feel to have that C on you? You know, I have the A, so I don't understand how having the C is, but how does it feel to be the captain of the 16s?
Well, I'd say I'm a natural born leader, and I like to put the boys under my shoulder and really help them out as best I can, and be there for them and hype them up and really just buckle down.
Yeah, we love that. We love buckling down. Yeah. So
you once said, just buckle down.
Exactly. Yep. I said that last time I was on here. It was a great interview. You guys should watch it. And so with the 16th season, yeah, it's been going really good. And, you know, what positives have you taken out of this season?
Some positives have definitely been the boys really come together for wins. We've got a couple of wins where it's been a really tight game, and we find a way to win, and that's what we do best.
That's awesome. Now, obviously, last season you had a different coach. Now this season you're coached under the great Andrew Trimble. How has his coaching been this year for you? How has he helped you kind of get to where you can be?
I think Coach Trimble is one of the best coaches I've ever had. He's always there for me, whether it be on the ice or off the ice. And he's really organized and makes the boys do what they need to do.
Yeah, we love that. And now we have another interview here, and it's actually with the son of the Andrew Trimble. Baron Trimble will be up next.
All right, hockey fans, we have one of our youngest Wolves fans and also completed his first season of Learn to Play Hockey. Baron Trimble, welcome to the Wolves Hockey Show.
Yeah, this is so good that I'm so psyched with being in the Wolves Hockey Show right now.
That's great, buddy. Well, I know that you've been very jealous because your sister's been on twice and you haven't been on before. So this is a big deal. It's a big moment.
Yeah.
Now tell me, okay, you finished up your first season of Learn to Play Hockey. What do you like most about playing hockey?
Shooting all the goals.
Okay, cool. Do you think people who are watching this show, all the kids out there, they should give hockey a try and come out and skate at the rink?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. Great.
Yeah, and Evan used to not be my best friend, but now he is my best friend.
Yeah, it's funny. You build these relationships. You make tons of friends out there, and we like Evan now. That's good. Now, tell me, you're also a Wolves fan. You attended the 2018-19 EHL Premier Championship game in which the Wolves won 4-2. Tell me about some of the great moments you've experienced as a Wolves hockey fan.
Watching the Wolves hockey show.
That's your favorite part, is the Wolves hockey show?
Yeah.
Okay, well, it's the number one rated hockey team show.
I like watching it. I like being in it.
That's right. This is the best moment ever. Now, tell me what your plans are for next year. You're going into kindergarten. Are you planning on playing hockey?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
You're also going to hockey camp, of course.
Yep, you're going to hockey camp. Okay.
Yeah, but it's not like Roblox camping too. Like, it's not like that.
No, it's more like you gotta skate and you gotta get out and exercise. You can't be like just sitting behind a computer all day or doing something like that. It's like you gotta do an exercise.
Or you don't even have to sleep in tents.
That's right, you don't have to sleep in tents either. Well, you heard it here first from Baron Trimble. You don't have to sleep in tents. You can play hockey, and it's not like Roblox, right?
Yeah.
Okay. To conclude your interview, Bear, what are you looking forward to for the rest of the Wolves hockey season? We have a couple games left, and then playoffs. What are you looking forward to?
Thinking that they score all the goals, that they score all the points on overtime.
That's right. Get all the points, including on overtime, and then the Wolves maybe win a championship. What do you think of that?
Yeah.
Definitely. You heard it here first. Give them your best Sonic pose. Thank you very much. Nice job. Two great interviews there. Fisher Galuzzo first. Tell me about your impressions of Fisher as a hockey player.
I think he's one of those grinder-type players. I've seen him lay out some guys. I've also seen him put it in the back of the net multiple times. And, you know, he's gonna be a great player. He's going to be a fantastic player when he gets to at least our age. So, yeah.
I agree with you, Trimble. Now tell me about Baron Trimble. You've seen him skate many times, too. Tell me about him.
Well, he's just like Sonic. He's a speedster, isn't he? He's,
That's right.
Takes good pride in Sonic. Yeah. You know, you've seen him out there. He's flying all the time. He might skate faster than me.
That might be true.
Yeah, that's probably true.
Now tell me, we got some upcoming college commitments, some great players coming in the Wolves program, and now moving on to college hockey. First time about your roommate, John Wernley. Where's he going to go?
He's going to Assumption College. You know, it's great for him. He's a fantastic player, and he's also a great roommate, too. Me and him have had some really good times in the cottage, and, you know, had a great time, you know, having the smoke alarm go off because we're cooking steaks. And, you know, it's been a great time, and he's going to do well.
I think so, too. And he's ready to take the next step.
Yeah, so the next one that we had was Sergei Anisimov. Where did he go?
Yeah, so Sergei came to us. He played in another league and, you know, did pretty well, but wasn't getting that exposure. Came to the EHL this year, and 3 months later, he's looking at a college commitment. He's headed to Suffolk University right in downtown Boston. And he's, I think he's going to play as a freshman for a pretty good minute. He's a big, strong kid and ready to take that next step. So congratulations, John. Congratulations, Sergei. And last week, Shroma, where are you headed, buddy?
Oh, I'm going to the University of Louisville in Louisville, Kentucky. Made that decision about a couple days ago, actually.
What attracted you about to Louisville?
I mean, it's not a big school, but it's not a small school. It's like right in the middle, and I felt like that's perfect for me. And really the sports management stuff, I thought that's perfect. That's just right where I want to be. Loved where the team was, and yeah, I think it's a fantastic place, and I think that's a place I can be for the next 4 years.
Well, congratulations, Shroma. Congratulations, John, Sergey. I think we all made some really good choices, and not just hockey-related choices, but also those schools all had their major, always ready to take that next step academically too. So, really positive.
Yeah, definitely.
Now tell me about upcoming events. 14s, who they got next weekend?
The 14s, they play against Manchester, and they play on Saturday. And Coach, tell us about the 16s. What do they have next?
16s have two home games against the Northern Cyclones. They're playing their elite team at 12:15 on Saturday. They're following that up on Sunday against their premier team at the same time, 12:15. It'll be two good games. We look to continue our winning ways against a good organization. What's going on with the P team?
The P team play Friday against the Lumberjacks in Waterville. This will be a really good game because, you know, we're obviously going to be playing these guys in the playoffs. So if we can get a couple wins against them before playoffs start, I think we can have the momentum going our way.
Agreed. It's always a battle with those guys, but I think that, it's just one or two bounces going our way that makes all the difference.
Yeah. And so what about the EHL? What do they got going on?
The EHL have finished up their Granite Cup series, and now it's just these last couple games prior to playoffs. And they're jockeying for position, whether they're going to be second in the division or third in the division. It makes a big difference because we want to get that home ice advantage for the playoffs. And I think that the team is really playing some of their best hockey right now. We have a game on Thursday and then Saturday, both against New Hampshire Avalanche, who we've beaten the last two times. But it's always a tough opponent, so we've got to make sure that we're buckling down, ready to play.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, Saturday is a big event. That's probably our biggest event of the year in terms of our community service program. It's the JBT game. Last year, you were in the building for the JBT game. Tell me about your impressions, Shroma.
Oh, it feels like a high school game. It just packs up. Everyone's excited for that shootout, and, they stay to watch some really good hockey. So, yeah.
Yeah. And, this year's going to be a little bit different. It's our pandemic 2021 version. So it's going to be done a lot remotely. We have the game available on YouTube. That'll be a live feed that's free of charge. It'll also be available on Facebook. They'll have that up on the Facebook page. So you can just click on those social media access points and be able to watch the game for free. And then, like you said, the shooters make a big difference. So with people contributing to those shooters so they can get more shots in the shootout, and earn some bragging rights. Right now, our donations are at $5,000. Our goal is to be at $15,000, which is a little bit shy of our normal goal of $25,000. But cancer didn't take the year off.
No, it didn't.
COVID has dominated the theme all year, but cancer didn't take the year off. So we want to raise money for a great cause like that.
Right. No, exactly.
We got a clip we're going to show you right now of John Bradley. So this clip is from 2013. John endured a 7-month battle with DIPG. This was his last day at chemotherapy. He's incredibly excited, doing his happy dance, coming out of chemotherapy. We always keep John's spirit with us as we play these games for this great cause and remembering him and his fight and his family as we play this important game every single season. Make sure those donations come in. Cancer hasn't taken the year off. So the game is this Saturday, 5:45 p.m. right here at the Merrill Fay Arena. You can donate through social media, either those particular shooters, whether it's Ronnie Lean, Chris Day, Joe Spicuzza, Britt Hart, Neil Ravin, any one of those shooters on their Facebook pages, you can click on the link and donate $5, $10, $15, doesn't matter. Nobody's judging. Just contribute to a great cause. And then that'll earn them more pucks in the shootout. And then they'll get some bragging rights and an opportunity to raise money for a great charity. Shroma, what do you think? What do you think about the JBT game?
I think that this is a great cause. I think that this game really helps, you know, put a end to cancer. And, you know, I think that we're honoring a legacy of a child who unfortunately lost his life to this disease.
Yeah. And he's, you know, he fought for those 7-8 months, and his family means a lot to this community. And we want to do the right thing. So donate today. Thanks for tuning in.
Imagine finding the cure for cancer. Not a cure for a cancer, but the cure for all cancers. Experts believe it starts with the most difficult cancers, like childhood brain cancer and DIPG. It's the home run cure. But unlike other cancer charities, it's our mission. Then again, we're not like other cancer charities. The Cure Starts Now is an organized, passionate group with a single goal: cure cancer. We have a plan, a strategy, a process. We don't throw darts at a wall and see what sticks. We research the why, the what, and the how, all with the end game in mind. We innovate. We spark change, taking chances on new ideas when no one else will. We are open. We are efficient, effective. Breakthroughs cannot and do not happen in a bubble. There has to be collaboration, communication, and never duplication. And all of this is working. We have funded new drugs and treatments, bringing them to trial 3 times faster, innovated drug delivery methods, established the first comprehensive database of childhood brain cancer, and built one of the first virtual hospitals, bringing expert treatment and care closer to patients. And it's making an impact, as survival times for the deadliest of childhood cancers have nearly doubled. So don't just imagine the cure for cancer. Be the change that finds it. The cure starts now.
For more information and to donate to the JBT charity, The Cure Starts Now, visit our website, www.ne-wolveshockey.com.